Shalom.
Shalom.
Hebrew Israelites coming in, week out, you know, proclaiming the downfall of this wicked society. But first and foremost, we want to give all praises to
Yahweh, Bashem, Yahweh Shai.
That will honor the apostles and elders of Great Millstone for teaching us the scriptures, among other things, and salutations to all your Akim across the earth for doing this work in sincerity and in truth.
Shalom.
Shalom.
Shalom. Would you like me to teach with you?
Yeah, come.
Shalom. Shalom.
Yeah,
man.
So basically, what I want to go into today, there are a lot of signs, that shows us that we are, that basically this is the final stretch, things are getting heavier, I also notice it in my spirit, because a lot of times, you want to do stuff, you'll be like, okay, today, when I come home from my job, you come home from your job, my weekdays like this. I go to my job and I come home. I got a few minutes basically, fresh up, maybe eat a piece of food, like a banana or something. Then I go to the gym and I come home. Then I have to cook, make some food. And then sometimes I'll be like, okay, when I'm done eating, and I will make a video, But sometimes the spirit, it gets you so tired, even when you go to bed, like today. You'll be like, okay, today I'm going to sleep early,
Yeah.
So I'm going to make sure that I have 8 hours of rest, But you wake up, you're still tired.
Yeah,
you're still tired. And why are you tired? Because also in the spirit, you're sick and tired of the situation, The more you understand, the more it's sickening,
Yeah,
matter of fact, let me go real quick to the book of Ecclesiastes. Because that's also a thing, the more you understand of this life that you are living, that things ain't supposed to be like that, the more it's vexing, the more it's a battle for you to do those things, like get up in the morning and to go to your job, let me see, this is the book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 7, verse 7, surely oppression maketh a wise man mad, and a gift destroy the heart, because to the spirit of Yahweh, Basham Yahushua, we have this understanding, we have the understanding of things, we see the things for what they are, and those things get you angry, and still you have to function, still you have to, take care of your daily bread, still if you have a household, take care of your household, and don't expect much from a female, She could be your wife, she could be raising up your children, but don't expect her to be in order, Just expect her 99 times of the hundreds times to be out of order, I've been witnessing this myself, and you can get angry, but it won't bring nothing, it's better than just to already incalculate, like, okay, she's gonna do something stupid, then when she does something stupid, it doesn't vex you that much because you already expected it, don't expect much from a female, because in the kingdom they're going to be righteous. Look, man, as we as men, as the men who doing the works of Yahweh, Basham, Yahweh Shai, the scripture already explains us that our righteousness is already like filthy rags, so what about them, and if you have a wife, don't expect her to follow Yahweh, Basham, Yahweh Shai, the scriptures in 1 Corinthians chapter 7, Apostle Paul explains us, if she's happy to dwell with you, if she doesn't hinder you to do the work, if you like, say you want to study, let's say you live together, you want to study, and she makes sure she doesn't erupt you or disturb you, that you study, it's good, that's already enough, and yeah, my advice, let me talk for my, I know for myself, I can't live with a woman, I can't live with my woman. I know I can't, because if I would live with my woman, I wouldn't be with her. I know that. Sometimes after a day already, I'm like, man,
Yeah, man.
I'm already on that level, like, ready to explode, God, you got three, sir?
Yeah. It's Ecclesiastes chapter 7, verse 28. I'm going to start in verse 27. Behold, this I found, Slacker. Behold, this have I found, said the preacher, counting one by one to find out the account, which yet my soul seeketh, but I found not. One man among 1,000 have I found.
So, among the 1,000 men, there was one man found who was righteous. Among 1,000 men.
One man among a thousand have I found, but a woman among all those have I not found.
And among a thousand women, he didn't find one woman who was righteous. And this is in the past time. This is way back, you know. If those men from back then, you know, would like go to a time warp, you know, and get in this time and see how the females are nowadays, they would go crazy, you know, because back then, what they were calling a wicked woman back then, for now, for us, is already something like, hey, she's trying to be righteous, you know, if you compare that, you know.